So hey, hello everyone. So in this video I'm going to show you how to construct a use case diagram for library management system. So it's going to be a very simple one, and I opened my staruml over here. It's a really good tool for creating software engineering diagrams. So let's get started. So just go to your model and go to add diagram, and you will have a list of diagrams over here. So for us, we are going to do use case. So here it is. Just select use case diagram and you will have all the necessary objects to construct a diagram. So in our case of library management system, there is going to be like two actors or the main characters that we are going to perform. They are going to perform the actions. So as you know, it's going to be the one is a librarian who controls the library and does the controls over all the process and stuff. And another one is going to be the common user that's going to use. So it's going to be a customer like that, customer or student, whatever you can keep it. So let's just select that actor and place it over here. Okay, so just change it as student. Okay, so the second actor is going to be, as you know, it's going to be the librarian, librarian. So that's good. So now it's an important task. So we are going to construct all the tasks that the two persons are going to perform. So basically, this number of tasks that these two persons are going to perform is basically just going to depend on the marks that you are going to assign for this question. Okay, so basically, like, I think in my opinion, you can have like overall 10 tasks. Okay, that can be done. So let's begin. So just go to the use case. Okay, just select one and paste it over here, and select one and paste it. I think there's some shortcut also, I think, but I will do this. Okay, so that's good. First, let's do the third three. So our first use case is going to be, as you know, register. So register. So this is going to be the first use case, and the next one is going to be, as you know, login. And this login is common for both the student and the librarian. But in case of register, because register is exclusive for the students, because any person who is new is coming to access the library and they can just register and login. But librarian is pre-registered, I would say. They will while creating the site itself, they would have the access, so they are pre-registered themselves. So no need to assign register for the librarian. So login is going to be common for both student and librarian. So it's also really important to have this common stuff. Like, you need to have exclusive for student also and exclusive for librarian also, and you need to also have some use cases common for both the students and librarians. It should be a mix. Okay, so that's really gives a good impact on opinion about your diagram. So the next use case is going to be search books. Okay, so books are going to be searched by students. Okay, students are like, they are going to just search, or the customer is going to just search the books. Okay, so that's our next use case. And next one is going to be modify the book stock. Okay, modify books. Okay, so this is like for adding new books, for updating the existing books, and for changing the prices, like giving some any changes in terms of discounts like that in terms of books, the librarian. So this is exclusive for the librarian to do. Okay, so this modify the books, it's basically book stocks. Okay, and another one is going to be student is going to have more number of use cases. It's obvious. Okay, another one is going to be place orders. Okay, so it's going to be the place where the user or the consumer is going to place the order for books, and it's going to just have a history of orders that you've done in the past. So this is exclusive for student. Okay, let me just arrange all this stuff. Okay. Okay, that's cool. And so it's going to be like a penalty or fine. Okay, penalty or fine. Okay, for late submission, or if there is any due in submission of book. So this is also exclusive for students. So if you want more exclusive for librarian, you can go with notifications. Okay, notifications. So this is exclusive for the library, because if the librarians wants to send any information regarding any new arrival of books, like any offers, any discounts, like that, like if the student recommended books, if they have like what the student likes, the librarian can just literally recommend, notify the students. So this is exclusive for librarian. And another exclusive for librarian is going to be like total sales. Okay, total sales of profit, books sold, how many people have ordered, total sales and statistics. Okay, I would say sales statistics. That's the perfect word. Statistics. Okay, total sales statistics. That's really a new thing. Okay, it's really a good one. The exclusive for librarian. Okay, and you can also like this is I think it's more than enough. Okay, to be saying you can also add like other things like book status, return book, change password, and feedback options, and like for librarian, in case of librarian, you can add like a verify a member, the member count, and the priority of each member. Like that's not only the sales statistics but also how many books that each member read, like that. Consumer statistics also, like these are the basic other things that you can add, but this is more than enough, I think. So register, login, search books, modify books is also like it's not required, I would say. It's not that much needed. Find notifications, sales statistics, I think it's quite important. It's exclusive for librarian because we have very few exclusive ones for librarian, and you need to mention that also. So for in case of arrows, just go with that and association, and okay, one, and register is unique, and you can go with okay, it's not coming. Student is for login. Student search books. Okay, so I'll go with for librarian because student is just basically like common. So for librarian, login is going to be a thing. Librarian can also search books. That's your wish. You can like add, modify books. Okay, and place order is for that, and notifications. Okay, notifications. And total sales statistics, and rest are all like for student itself. So you can just draw arrow mark like it, and so I think this is really good. I think so, because I think I will check again. Register is only for student, login is for both. Search, modify, no, it's okay. Modify books is for only librarian, okay. Place order is for student, penalty or fine is for student. Notification for librarian can send to the students, and total sales is for librarian. So we have like, we have some exclusive for student, we have exclusive for librarian, and we have some common for both. So like I would say this is a complete use case diagram for staruml in software engineering for library management system. You can also do your own modification, customize it, like you can do anything with it. So I think this is more than enough in case they ask you any question. So that's it for this video, and mine is a programming channel. I run tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Blender, Unity and other stuff. So feel free to check other videos of my channel, and kindly subscribe and support me, and thanks for watching.